Simon & Schuster Audio presents What the Chicken Knows, a new appreciation of the world's most familiar bird. By Sy Montgomery. Read by the author.
For Gretchen Vogel Morin, who gave us our first flock. Introduction. Imagine. You are lying on the ground, once again attempting to fix the ancient riding lawnmower you inherited from your home's previous owner. Just beyond the narrow space between the grass and the machine's metal undercarriage, movement catches your eye. Scaly, reptilian yellow feet, heavily armed with long pointed claws, and just above the toes, curved, knife-sharp spurs are purposefully striding towards you at face level. It feels like that scene from Jurassic Park, where the humans are hiding from the hunting velociraptor, an animal from which, in fact, your avian assailant is descended. You have been detected. The ominous feet hurry now, pounding the ground in a frenzy. There is no mistaking it. This is a rooster on a rampage, the bane of many an otherwise peaceful barnyard. Unless you're on the receiving end of those spurs, it may look, at least to others, hilarious. A 2-foot-tall bird, mostly made of air, weighing only 6 pounds, can easily scare a 150-pound, 6-foot-tall human being into running away. But an angry rooster can draw blood. What should you do? Years ago, my husband joined the ranks of the many backyard chicken farmers, their kids, and their visitors who have been unexpectedly confronted with this very dilemma. His quite reasonable reaction was, like most of our poultry-keeping colleagues, to spring to his feet and hastily get out of the way. But now, many years later, my neighbor, Ashley Nagley, suggests a different course of action, one that is staggeringly counterintuitive. In this situation, it's best, she insists, to pick them up. What? Cuddle them, she continues. Talk to them in a soft voice. Do your chores while you're holding them close. Watch out for the beak, she advises, because he might bite. If possible, wrap the rooster's feet in a towel or a blanket to protect yourself from his spurs, but gathering the angry bird into your arms and carrying him around is, she assures, the best and only foolproof way to train a rowdy rooster to become a loving friend. By the time I spoke with Ashley, my husband and I had lived among chickens for decades, including the occasional rooster or two. The guys had all started out as sweet baby chicks, turned into affectionate and assertive young cockerels, and some of them remained perfect gentlemen their whole lives. But occasionally we'd get one who changed. Then what? We'd never heard of Ashley's training method. When we began keeping chickens in the late 1980s, way before the internet with its advice for all matters at your fingertips, way before the pandemic craze for backyard poultry, we had no idea how to contend with a rooster gone rogue, other than to find him another home. Now we know what to do. Our travels in what I call the chicken universe, as you shall see in the following pages, have been a multi-decade voyage, a journey of revelation. New discoveries continue to this day. In 2023, a study published in the journal PLOS ONE reported that roosters recognize their own reflections in mirrors, a common, though contested, measure of self-awareness. Previous experiments show that apes, like humans, do this. When chimps who are familiar with mirrors are knocked out and their faces marked with red dye, they'll examine their faces in the glass and touch the red marks, showing they recognize the reflection as their own. But male birds are famous for attacking their own reflection in the window. especially disturbing when the bird is a cassowary, a 5-foot-tall, 120-pound flightless native of Australia and New Guinea, who can break a plate glass window with a single kick. Up till last year, roosters failed the mirror test. But then a German scientist tried another way. Sonja Hellmacher, a University of Bonn researcher, gave roosters time in a mirrored enclosure. But how to tell if they recognize themselves? Knowing that roosters warn others of danger, she projected a hawk silhouette over the test roosters to see what they'd do. When another rooster was visible through the partition, the subject of the experiment tried to warn his comrade of the danger. But if there was nothing but mirrors around, no other chickens than himself to be seen, the test rooster was always silent. The researcher actually found this unsurprising. She knew roosters were smart. The difficult part of her work was devising an experiment that was biologically relevant, one that related to things that the rooster encounters in his daily life. That takes patience and careful observation. Exactly what makes Ashley's barnyard findings as eye-opening as those from Hellmacher's lab. It takes time and effort to have a gentle rooster, Ashley explains, as fat snowflakes fall into her long brown hair. She and her husband and two kids offer to educate me on this cold January day. We huddle in our parkas inside one of their many spacious backyard coops. Daughter Brooke, 14, scoops up a handsome red cockerel named Charlie, who instantly snugs his comb and waddles into her hair, which is long and dark like her mother's. They love snuggling into hair, Ashley's husband Brian notes. Some people grow up thinking roosters are mean, Brooke says, but you just have to build trust. Roosters look big and intimidating, says Brooke's brother Tyler, age 12, but if you treat them right, with respect and kindness, they'll be calm. This family speaks from experience. They have been rescuing and rehabilitating rowdy roosters for a decade now. Their travels in the chicken universe started when Brooke was 5 and Tyler was 3. While Brian was working as a mechanic, Ashley was then a stay-at-home mom. They purchased 2 ducks and added 6 young New Hampshire red pullets, what hens are called, before age 1, for the eggs. The chickens loved playing with the kids. Brooke would often take a youngster on her lap when she played on the swing. The kids napped with the chickens, found worms for them, stroked them. The little flock ranged freely over their lawn and fields while Ashley watched over them. But one day, during the few minutes when she stepped inside to get Tyler a drink, a fox killed one of the hens. It was Star, one of their favorites. Star was only 3 months old. It was devastating. We were all heartbroken. But Ashley knew what she had to do to protect the others. I realized, she said, that I needed a rooster. A rooster watches for danger. With his loud voice, he alerts his hens to any coming threat. And while they take cover, he will often courageously attack the intruder. Because of his spurs and his spunk, a brave rooster may, in fact, successfully drive away a much larger predator. Brian, in fact, once watched in amazement as Charlie chased a fox out of their yard. Luckily, Ashley's mom, who lives in Vermont, had just brought 3 roosters over to Brian's grandmother. They were Easter chicks who turned out to be roosters, Ashley said. 2 roosters remained on her grandmother's farm, and Ashley took one, a large and stately golden buff Orpington, whom she named Cooter. Cooter charmed the family, both avian and human. He was curious and unusually observant. He loved to watch me work on the car, Brian says. He'd watch me for 5 or 6 hours at a time. Then, when Brian was finished, Cooter, who has since died of old age, would come and intently inspect the shiny tools as if trying to figure out how to replicate what the mechanic had just accomplished. With his flock, Cooter was very proactive, but also kind and gentle, Ashley tells me. He'd show the hens where the food was, but he wouldn't eat it himself, letting them have first dibs. And he always had his eye on the sky, watching for a hawk. If he saw one, he'd scream and I'd come running. The kids adored him and were always carrying him around, snuggling him. He never attacked. He seemed to enjoy their gentle touch. Cooter's affectionate attention to his flock soon had...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.